Hello children, welcome to another session of the chapter Crop Production and Management. The last few classes, you've gone through the video sessions when you had seen the farmer actually working on the field, what all implements he is using for his agricultural techniques, what are the different methods of irrigation. So let us just summarize the lesson. You all remember that food is very important for our growth and for all other activities that are going on in our body, and it is also required for the plants. Now, where is this food coming from? Definitely, the farmer is our feeder. He is the one who feeds us. So how does he do that? For that, let us just learn about the crop. As you all might be remembering, what are crops? They are the plants of the same kind that are grown and cultivated as a source of food in a large cultivable land. There are two types of crops in India, the rabi crops and the kharif crops. The rabi crops are the crops that are grown in the winter season, that is from the months October to March, whereas the kharif crops are grown mostly in the rainy season, that is from July to October. But these crops that are growing in India, in our country, are they the same throughout the country? No. The type of crops grown in the different parts of the country vary according to the climate there, the soil there, and of course, on the rainfall that they receive. So what are agricultural activities? You have learned that the farmer or the gardener, he undertakes a lot of activities as he is growing a crop. So all these activities together, they are called agricultural practices. As you have learned that agricultural practices, there are many types, like preparation of the soil is there, then tilling, which includes tilling or plowing, and all adding manures, adding fertilizers, sowing, harvesting, storage, etc. So let us go to them one by one. Preparation of the soil is the first and the most important activity that a farmer takes up. What is this preparation of soil? Now, as you all prepare yourselves before undertaking any activity, or as we teachers prepare ourselves before coming to your class, similarly, the soil also has to be prepared before he starts his agricultural technique. That is a very important step in agriculture, which is called preparation. Preparation is the first step in the cultivation of crops for food production. The soil is prepared for sowing the seeds. This is carried out by using various processes and tools. Now you might be wondering, why is this preparation of soil required? Well, the soil has got some big crumbs of rock particles. Some big pieces are there. Unless they are broken down into smaller particles and made uniform, sowing process cannot be done. So that is the first reason why preparation of soil is a must. The soil has to be prepared so that the bigger crumbs can be broken down into smaller crumbs so that the land becomes uniform, the land becomes even, and the sowing can be done. The second necessity of preparation of soil is that the soil becomes loose. The soil becomes well aerated. Only when the soil becomes well aerated can the soil breathe properly, can the supply of oxygen be more efficient in the soil, and then only the soil will be suitable for the growth of the crops. Third reason why preparation of soil is required is that this preparation helps in the growth of the farmer's friend. Who are the farmer's friends? The farmer's friends are the earthworms and the tiny microbes that are living in the soil. What do? They add humus to the soil. So when the soil is prepared, automatically the earthworms and the microbes, they get an opportunity to grow there, and they add the humus to the soil, which provides nutrients to the plants. The dead plants, the decayed parts of the plants also get mixed up in the soil. They also add nutrients to the soil. Apart from all that, the bottommost part of the soil is turned up to the topmost part so that they will also receive sunlight, and uniformly they get all the nutrients. So you have heard, you have seen that preparation of the soil involves a very important process that is called tilling or plowing. Now you might have understood what is this tilling and plowing. Tilling or plowing is nothing but loosening and turning of the soil. The process of loosening and turning of the soil is called tilling or plowing, and it is done by using a plow. It is a device. Plow is a device that is used by the farmer for different purposes. It can be used for adding fertilizers, for tilling, and for loosening. It is also used for adding fertilizers to the soil, removing the weeds, scraping the soil, etc. What does the plow look like? The plow is a triangular iron strip. A plow shaft is a main part of the plow, which is made by using a log of wood. You can see the picture of the plow on the screen. It is a triangular iron strip. The plow shaft is a main part of the plow, which is made by using a log of wood. The other end of the shaft has a handle. The other end is attached to a beam, which is placed on the bull's neck. A wooden traditional plow can be operated by a pair of an ox or even by a man. But nowadays, these wooden plows are being replaced by the iron plows. So you might have understood now what does a traditional wooden plow look like. Now we go to the next agricultural implement, that is a hoe. Hoe is also a tool that is used to dig up the soil, to remove the weeds, and also loosen up the soil before planting a sapling. It has got a blade-like structure and it has got a handle. You can see the diagram on the screen. Now we go to the cultivator. Cultivator is attached to the tractor and it helps in loosening of the soil. What is the process of loosening also called? It's also called tilling or plowing. So a cultivator is attached to the tractor and it helps in loosening the soil. Cultivators are used instead of the plows because they are much faster. Now we go to the next step or next agricultural practice, that is sowing. What is sowing? Sowing is nothing but the process of planting the seeds in the soil. Now, you cannot just take the seeds in the hand and throw them randomly. You can understand what will happen. The seeds might blow away with the wind, or it might go away along with the water, or it might get damaged, or it might get eaten up by the animals. So there is a scientific process required for the process of sowing also. So sowing is the process of planting the seeds in the soil, and the seeds are sowed in the soil that has already been loosened by a cultivator or a plow. Now you've already seen a video in our class, in our previous class, about the quality of the seeds. How do you judge the quality of the seeds? Quality of the seed is an important factor for determining the crop yield. Selection of good seed is very important. Farmer takes a lot of care in selecting good quality seeds. He first puts the seeds in the water. The damaged ones are floating in the water. The good quality seeds, they settle down. So in this way, they select the good quality seeds. The dead and damaged seeds become hollow and they float, whereas the good seeds sink down. Now we come to the traditional tools that were used by the farmers. Before, for the purpose of sowing, they were using some traditional tools. Before the beginning, advent of modern agricultural machinery, traditional tools like the plows, shovels, the pickaxes, etc. were used. The traditional tool that was used for sowing was like a funnel. You all know what is a funnel looks like. So once the seeds are put into the funnel, they would pass through two or three tubes having sharp ends. The ends will pierce into the soil and place the seeds there. But then this method had its disadvantage because it was not necessary that all the seeds would germinate. Moreover, the seeds were not sown keeping a proper distance between them. So it was not at all a scientific method, and there was no guarantee that the seeds would germinate. So there was a very safe method, that was by using the seed drill. What are seed drills? Seed drills are used for sowing with the help of tractors. It ensures that the seeds are sown uniformly at a particular depth and are covered by the soil after sowing. So this is, of course, machinery is used. It is done with the help of a machinery and the farmers are doing it. It is a foolproof method. The damages that we saw or the disadvantages that we saw while using a funnel is not there by this method. Now we go to the nursery. Nursery, you all are familiar with the word nursery. A nursery is a place where young plants and trees are grown for planting elsewhere. Nursery also acts as a repository of saplings. Now we go to germination of seeds. What does germination mean? Germination means when the seed is sown in the land and it is watered, after a few weeks, a new plant starts to emerge from the seed and starts to grow. That is called germination.